here. I'm very overdue for this video, but it's not exactly going to be the full video where I talk about my entire insulator collection. Harry Holmstone, if you're watching this video, I'm sorry that I'm overdue for this, but I'm going to be doing part video episodes of this where I will talk about American glass insulators, Canadian glass insulators, maybe foreign glass insulators, colors, styles, and manufactured names of insulators, and maybe a brief history about glass insulators, but there's many out there, but I wanted to personally do my opinion about them as well, and to my knowledge about what I know about. But in today's video, I'm just going to be specifically talking about, like, what is going on with the collection right now. Well, I could say that I have currently over 300 glass insulators right now, and I keep a chart about how many that I have, the color and the style, the name and embossings, all that such. Also, quick update, people who remember the Ottawa swap meet, and if you haven't checked that out, check it out right up here, or just wait to the end of the video to check out that link. And the Ottawa swap meet, that was a lot of fun that I did last year. Thankfully that the people who hosted the swap meet, it's going to happen again this year, so keep an eye out for that video. That will come in late in October or maybe late September. The swap meet's in September, so maybe I might do a live stream, so keep an eye on that. I try to do my videos as much as I can, but in today's video, just going to do a quick update about the insulators and what I did. And first off is the backlit desk that I worked on this year. So before getting to the backlit insulator display, there's two different ways that some insulator collectors like to display their insulators, and one of them is backlit, and the other one that I like to do as well is underglow, which I see it shows occasionally, but, oh, well, it depends on how what the insulator collector likes to do. It's just their personal opinion. I like both. So starting with this one here on the left, my most recent piece, I bought this orange amber frog eyes from David Watkins, who specializes in insulators with junk in them. The reason why this one has junk in it is because it's got the bubbles inside of it around the edge of it near the base, which is nice, so that basically qualifies as insulator with junk in it. And continuing on some of the pieces that you've seen later in my years of collecting insulators, here's another addition that I have is this electric supply company Chicago insulator. And next, you can see some pieces that you remember seeing in my previous videos. And coming up right here near the end by the carnival glass, is right next to it, is this dark yellow-green Hemming Gray signal. Very difficult to come by these days. And compared to next to it is a yellow-green beehive that's off-center with the threads in there. Now getting to the backlit case. The top shelf, I have insulators with amber swirls in it, or mostly what people would call as amber junk inside of it. I've even seen insulators with a lot of heavy junk in it. Some Brookfields and Star Keg that I got from Gene Hawken a couple years ago. And if y'all remember this green, what I seem to be thought that was green, Canadian National 143 beehive that I got from the Ottawa swap meet last year. I thought it was just green, but it's hard to see it, but there's amber swirls in it that make it green, which what makes it very unique. And next to it is a Brookfield 101 mushroom top in olive amber, which is one of those really, really beautiful colors that I have. It also has a shop number one that's on there. There's many different shop numbers on them. I can't remember which one was the rarest, but why olive amber? It's because it was olive and it's got all those amber streaks in it that make it this brown color, which is really nice. And another piece from the Ottawa swap meet is this number two transposition insulator made by Hemming Gray. It's got a lot of amber swirls in it. And next to it, a Brookfield cable number three. This one I find it very unique because I paid $13 for this on eBay. It's in mint condition. It has amber swirls in it and it's got some carbon junk, factory defect, and bubbles. Literally the deal of the year from what I could say. And you can also see some of these more bubbles up here and some carbon junk up right there. So very unique piece. I've told this about insulator about to other people, but obviously that usually pictures don't usually tell a story unless if they see it in person. And then continuing on, just a couple more Brookfields, and also that petticoat on the far left with the bubble and the amber in it. Very nice pieces. So let's get to the bottom shelf next. So starting from the right, I have another yellow-green beehive star embossing, but one half has more amber than the other half, which gives it that odd appearance, if you could see that on camera. And next to it is one of my few rare insulators that I have in my collection. It's a Fall River's Police Signal. Quick history behind it is that when the Fall River's Police Department in Massachusetts, Fall River's, they commissioned the Brookfield Company that made glass insulators at that time. They made, between 1900 and 1915, they made less than 1,000 of these. They only came in aqua and light aqua, but this one is light aqua, but the way that I see it, it's light aqua, but the camera's showing it like it's more aqua. So it's kind of a weird thing, but it's better to see them in person so you get exactly which color it is. Next to it is another Denver in a nice, beautiful purple. And a McLaughlin in emerald green, which is a beautiful color, very dark green. Next to it is a Boston Barrel from Canada. Boston Barrels, there are different types of them. This is the Canadian one. There's also the American one that was made by the Boston Bottle Works. Different threads, slightly different appearance, but I got the Canadian one because it was cheaper. And it's in, like I just said, sky blue, which is a beautiful color, and it's got some dome glass in it so you can see that color pop. I got this for a steel because it had some small chips on it, and also you can see the chips by the base and one little chip on the wire groove. But the most recent auction that I've seen that sells really high-end insulators, one of these was on there and it was in mint condition. It sold for about or over $400, so I don't know why. It was just over book price in the price guide, but somebody really wanted it. But I still say in this color, I say that it would probably be worth that much, but maybe they'll increase to that price later on in time. Another Denver, it's a toll, and next to it is a Canadian threadless insulator. A little bit of damage, but I wanted it because it's something that I don't have. It's my first threadless insulator that I have. And next to it is another unique piece that I have. They don't come up for sale that much, and people like to collect these. It's a CD110.5. It's an American threadless, reverse threads that's on top of it, or what we call as corkscrew. This was made by the National Insulator Company back in the early days. Story goes is that somebody found a bunch of these along the line, and there's two versions of this one. There was a bigger one, and the big ones of these are really rare to find, but on one pole there would only be 12 of these, and then the big one on top, which would be really nice. And reason why the threads are reversed on the outside is that when you screwed them down on the threaded pegs that are on the cross arms, the wire would catch the top and then it would thread its way down to the wire groove, which made this a very unique insulator. And I got this for about what they go for book price. Small little chip, but what makes it valuable to me is that it's got a little bit of amber right there, that little like brown streak that's right there. And a California beehive in a purple, and Western flint glass. Top of it is more purple, but the bottom looks like maybe it's just a little bit less purple, or it's got some straw color to it where the sunlight didn't hit it. Some Denver glass insulators, when they were made, they came out as a straw peachy color to them, but when they got exposed to the sunlight, they turned purple. The more magnesium is inside of it, they will go darker purple. There's even something called black purple that Western Glass Manufacture did to some of their insulators, where they had so much magnesium in there, they just turned like almost black glass, but it was purple. Now coming over here is some of the other insulators that I have. The Muncie that you remember in my previous videos. Some more oddity stuff. Some other bottom lid stuff that I have. And this nice blue beehive that's right back here. It's an American beehive. It's got base embossings on the bottom of it. All the American insulators would have embossings on the bottom. I don't know if you can see that, but this is prior 1900s, so it's really early stuff, like right around the year after when they started to make insulators with threads in them. Like, the threads go up like maybe a quarter of the way or almost near the top, and the rest of it is just completely bare, which I like about that. And then the dark green and the amber in there, the Brookfield in mint condition, or olive green or something like that, a really oddity stuff. And one of these oddball insulators in orange amber. A couple more. Another oddity right here. I don't remember the CD number for that. Some more transposition insulators. And also another recent piece that I got is this beautiful hemi blue cross top. A little bit of chips, but it was a little bit of chips, but I decided to get it. Another oddity, I found that at the Volo Auto Museum, and the Pyrex behind it, and also the little serge that's on top. It's one of three that I have, but they're very nice insulators to collect. A little bit more that's just extra that I have here, but it's some that is listed from what I have. I don't really have that many duplicates. Duplicates that I have, I just give them away to people that would really want some. Some more that I have back over here, and another junk insulator that I have right here is this beehive right here. You can see all those little bubbles in it. That's basically what junk and glass is like, or basically we call these snowy insulators because it looks like snow that's in there. Still some oddity stuff as well. It says more Brookfields that I have right here. And a friend of mine gave this to me for Christmas. It's one of these insulators that somebody would heat up and then they wrap a towel around it and it would shatter like this. So this is one of those insulators that's basically been fiddled with where it just gives it that effect that it was never hit. Because the story that I thought was is that it was struck by lightning and it turned into that. And the pleated skirt that's right there I got from the Ottawa Swamp Meet last year, I might sell the other one that I have. And another oddity that I got is this Petticut 104. And this Lynchburg keg right here. It's got this error on it where, I don't know if you could see that, a bubble used to be there and it took out part of Lynchburg right there, which is really funny. Oddity stuff, I will show that to Gene Hawken because he specializes in those kind of insulators. Now the last few parts, I'll just go over here. Bookshelf, top shelf, it's got crown embossed insulators from A Little Pony, Bullet, and crown embossed Brookfield beehives, but basically insulators that have crown embossings on them. I do that as well, and my most unique piece that I have that's crown embossed is this one right here. It's a 143.5, very odd insulator. It's basically a 143 Canadian insulator that was extended taller, but these ones were made in America. And this is one of those insulators that doesn't come up for sale that much, and I was fortunate enough to get this. Very little damage, it just has the little two little chips right there that you can see at the front, but it's very near mint condition. Very nice insulator, and what makes it the reason why you don't see them come up for sale that much is that one of my friends that I know in the hobby says that he's been in the hobby for so long and he rarely sees these. He said it's been nearly or over 10 years since he's seen one of these 143.5s come up for sale. Planning on to show this to him at the swap meet, and that's coming up next month. Some more Brookfields. And I don't know which one of these is. There will be a later video that one of the embossings of the N for New York is backwards on them. And the big ponies right back there. And some more beehives. And some more of the modern stuff right there. And just some extra stuff that's just down there, like from hardware to rubber insulators and threaded pegs and such and plastic. And just sitting right over here is my Mickey Mouse and a Roman helmet cable with a Canadian 162.4s that are right over there. And then right up over by the window is just another collection of 162 signals in different variants. Some Californias up there and some hemi blues and such. Very beautiful colors. So that concludes my little bit of what is all in my collection right now, but I'm still gonna maybe do a whole video on my whole collection because of what Harry Holmstone had said. Check out his channel if you haven't heard about it. He does a lot of antique stuff, including glass insulators, and he loves my videos about glass insulators and such. But in the near future, I might do a series of glass insulators from insulators that I have in the collection to different colors, maybe some insulator hunting videos that I might do. I'm not sure because I don't go out as much anymore, but maybe, for example, I found one of those root beer or amber colored looking insulators. That was a weird thing that I found it up on a pole still, and it was a unique find and all that such. CV styles and also different colors and manufactured names. Maybe more insulator shows. The next one that is going to be happening soon is the Ottawa Swap Meet, which is in September. And I'm really hoping that the Springfield Insulator Show in Springfield, Ohio happens this year because this marks the 50th anniversary if it does happen. But because of COVID-19, we don't know what's going to happen, if the show is going to be canceled or not. We'll be really upset if it is. But if they do happen to have it, they might do precautions like you've got to wear a mask, you've got to bring hand sanitizer, all that such. But other than that, be sure to look out for future content on glass insulators and maybe a series that I might put together. So be sure to subscribe, like this video, and also click the notification bell so you won't miss out on my future content, so you know when I'll upload another video. So take care, and I'll see you next time.